हे फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज संपदा कुलकर्णी फ्रॉम टेक टॉक्स। हियर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द वीडियो सीरीज ऑन द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सर्क्यूलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। द सर्क्यूलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट वीडियो वेयर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाई टू लर्न सर्क्यूलर क्यू, वेयर आई हैड एक्सप्लेन द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ लीनियर क्यू। Then we move together for the next topic, is nothing but introduction to circular queue. After introducing the circular queue, I am moving forward to the features of a circular queue in the third video of this video series. After learning the features of a circular queue, I had gone through how CQ works, where I had explained you the working of a circular queue. Then in the next video, I had covered the topic how circular queue operates. Here I had explained the concept of front and rear pointers and how they help us for the operation of CQ. And now in this current video, I am explaining you the concept of insertion operation, how to perform insertion operation on a circular queue. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the insertion operation on a circular queue. First of all, let's cover some basic features of circular queue, where circular queue behaves just same as of a linear queue. All of you are knowing this. Then insertion or the enqueue operation are performed at the rear end of the queue, where we will use the rear pointer to perform insertion or enqueue operation. Initially, we are going to assume that the circular queue is empty, and to indicate that circular queue is empty, we suppose to assign -1 to rear and front. And here it indicates that the circular queue is empty. So now let's start with the initial state of a circular queue. The initial state of a circular queue, as I explained previously, both the values, both the pointers, both the indices that are front and rear, that we suppose to set them to -1 or initialize to -1, which indicates that the queue is empty. Now let's see the same condition, same situation, where I am initializing both front and rear to -1 to indicate that our circular queue is empty. Now let's move forward for the insertion or enqueue operation. So this insertion operation or enqueue operation, this function is used to perform the insertion or to insert an element into the circular queue. In a circular queue, the new element is always inserted at the rear position or at the rear end of a queue. So now let's see what the steps we supposed to follow while inserting the element on the circular queue. So the first condition is to check if queue is full or not. If the queue is full, we will display the message queue is full and we will exit from the function. Otherwise, we will move to the next step. Now, if the queue is full, we are not going to perform any operation. Now, let's assume that my queue is not full. So, that's why I move to the next condition or next step is nothing but, again here, we have to check if we are inserting the first element or not. If we are inserting a first element, by checking the front and rear at -1 position, it indicates that the queue is empty. And now here we are inserting the first element. So if we are inserting the first element, then we supposed to set both the rear and front variables, pointers, indices to the position 0, and then we will go to the step number 4 directly. Otherwise, if this is not the first element, that is your previously queue was not empty, already few elements are available, then we will go to the step number 3. So let's see first of all what is the step number 3. Here we have to increase the rare index by 1 but circularly. How to perform circular increment, that I have already explained in the previous video. If you are not knowing the concept of circular increment, then you can go through my previous video. Here in this right up corner I'm giving you a shortcut link for that video, so that it will help you to move that video directly. And after getting the concept of circular increment, resume this video again. Here we have to check that if the rare reaches to the end, then next would be the start of the queue, that is the zeroth element of the queue. To perform all these things, the circular increment will help us, and we will use the circular increment to move forward. Now after that, we have to go forward for the next, and the fourth step will be add or insert or enqueue the new element in the position of a rare pointer. And in this way we are going to perform the insertion operation. Now let's move forward for the next slide, where we are going to start for the insertion of the elements in a CQ, and that's why both the front and rear, that we have to initialize it to 0 to insert the first element. What was our first step? The first step was to check whether the queue is full or not. No, queue is not full, as it was initialized to -1. And now let's check whether the first element you are going to insert. Yes, and if it is first element, then both the rear and front pointer we supposed to initialize it to 0 and insert the first element. Go to step 4 and insert the element. So I have inserted the element at the rear position. Now let's move forward. Let's insert few more elements into CQ. For that, what we have to do? For this, we have to go forward for the next position by the circular increment. To perform circular increment, what we will do? We will use this formula. And here this formula will indicate you whatever the current rear position is there, that we have to perform addition on that, and then modulo 10. Why 10? Because the size of my queue is 10. So that's why modulo size of the queue. So 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 modulo 10 is nothing but the result will be 1, because it will find out not the division, it will find out the remainder, and remainder is nothing but 1, and which will get assigned to rare variable. And in this way, this rare will get updated to the position 1 in this like this. And now we'll go forward for the fourth step, where we are going to insert a new element. After insertion of the new element, let's insert a new one more element in your circular queue. For that, again let's perform the operation for the circular increment. So what is circular increment? Again, now my rare is at position 1. So now rare 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 modulo 10 is nothing but remainder will be 2. And my new rare will assign with the value 2. So let's remove this rare from this position and initialize it to 2. And let's go forward for the step number 4 and let's insert the element. In this way, the next value will get inserted by performing the circular increment. 2 plus 1 is 3, modulo 10 result will be 3, the remainder will be 3, which will get assigned to rare. So let's remove this rare and initialize it to the position 3. So here you can see that, and then let's insert the element at the third position. While performing all these things, every time we are going to check whether the queue is full or not. Queue is not full. Here you can visualize the thing like the still few space is available in a circular queue, and we can insert new element. So now let's perform circular increment. Let's move forward and insert a new value. Now let's insert few more elements in CQ. The same way we have to perform circular increment and insert a value, perform circular increment, insert a value. Every time we are going to check whether the queue is full or not. No, queue is not full. Here we can see that still queue is not full. Then insert a new element, perform a circular increment, and then insert a new element. Now let's move forward. Can I insert more elements in CQ? No, I can't. But why? Why I can't insert a new element in my circular cube? Now let's see this situation number 1, where here you can see that your rare is pointing at position 9, that is nothing but the maximum size of your circular cube, and front is pointing at position 0, which is nothing but the starting or the beginning of your circular cube. Let's check this condition. If my rare is equal to size minus 1 and if my front is equal to 0, if this is the condition, then can we say like this the circular cube is full? Can we say like this? Initially in this situation you can see that this condition is working and you can see that the circular cube is full, but let's check or think whether this condition is sufficient or not. To give the answer to this question, let's move forward for the situation number 2. Now let's consider my rear is at pointer 8 and front is at pointer 9. Let's check the condition. If my rear is at equal to size minus 1, whether this condition is true, rear is at 8 position and size is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9, this condition will become false, as well as front is not at 0 position, and this AND indicates that if either condition is false, we can say that the condition is false, the total condition is false. And here in this situation it may fail that though the cube is full, but this will not show that, this will not give that the cube is full. For that we have to take the help of another condition, where we are going to check if the both, that is rear and front, are at the consecutive positions or not, or the front is at the next position to rear or not. To check that, we will use the condition like rear is equal to front minus 1. Rear is 8 and front is at 9. Front minus 1 is 8. If both are equal, 8 equal to 8, both are at the same position, then from these two conditions, if either one is true, then we can say that the cube is full. And now this condition is sufficient and we can say that a circular cube is full. So in this way, we are going to check both the condition in both the situation. Otherwise, we can see that instead of checking these two conditions, the modulo division will help us to build a single condition. And that single condition is helpful for both the situation. So now let's check the condition. This is the situation 1, where rare is at the max minus 1 position, the size minus 1 position, and front is at 0. Whether the condition, modulo division condition, will help us. Here you can see that rare is at position 9, 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 modulo division 10, it will give the remainder 0. And let's check whether that the value of front is equal to the equation result or not. That is 0 is equal to 0. Yes, because front is pointing at 0 position. So it is working. It is showing that the condition is true to indicate that my circular cube is full. Now let's go forward for the situation number 2, where situation number 2, if my rear is at somewhere at the position 8 and front is at position 9. Let's check the condition again. Rear is holding value 8, 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 modulo division 10, what it will result is that it will result into 9. Let's check whether it is equal to the content of front variable or not. Yes, front is at position 9. So 9 equal to 9, both the left hand side and right hand side are equal, and then we can say that yes, my cube is full. And it indicates that for both the situation, the modulo division condition is helpful for us, and a single condition will help us to check all the situation, and it will help us to indicate that whether the circular cube is full or not. Now let's see the time complexity for the insertion operation. The time complexity of NQ or insertion operation is big O1, because there is no any loop here, as well as the straightforward algorithm is there, and that's why the time complexity is big O1. Thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my videos. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment, as well as do not forget to subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you a subscription link for this my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am giving you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series is nothing but the deletion operation on a circular queue, and the whole playlist also here I am presenting you for your reference. Thank you. Keep watching. Happy data structuring. Thank you.